You must oil your hair and tie them in two chotis. Keep your hands behind your back. Don't look sideways. Have you experienced such silly rules made by schools? Hi, welcome all to Musings of a Master. I'm Meenam Desai, and here I share a medley of my unique experiences shaped by students, teachers, and life in general. So, talking of rules, have you experienced these silly rules that we schools make? One child with long hair turns out to be indisciplined, everybody is subjected to short haircuts. This makes institutions rules obsessed, and we have maximum rules but minimal compliance. For example, talk of mobiles. All teenagers nowadays carry mobiles. The parents actually want them to carry it out of concerns for safety. But most schools have this no mobiles policy. The teachers know that the students are carrying mobiles, but they turn a blind eye to it. Why? Because they cannot frisk the students every single day. But one fine day when the child is caught carrying a mobile, a long diatribe ensues. So, how about instead creating a dialogue, working with students, and having a mobiles policy that is more conducive to today's time? How about asking students to leave the mobiles outside the classroom but may carry it to the school? Will such policies or working with students like this ensure that there is no offender ever? Of course not. There will be, but there will be far fewer. Also, there will be a lot of peer pressure to comply and to fall in line. Isn't that what we really want? Also, at times rules are taken as a substitute for faith and trust. It doesn't work that way. In this particular school, there was a problem of a lot of children munching food at the end of the during the class on the back benches and all that. The school realized this and scrapped its policy of no food in the classroom. It asked its students that you can have your food whenever you want. And you know suddenly what happened? The students stopped eating in the classroom. Why? Because it wasn't any more cool to do that. They started eating their snacks only during the snack and the lunch time. To sum up, rules are necessary to function. And there is no substitute for discipline. But only self-maintained discipline and rules that can be complied to work in today's day and age. Rules imposed by schools which are of an archaic nature do not work. Have you experienced such rules? Would you like to share some of them with me? Please feel free to do so, and don't forget to subscribe to Musings of a Mastery.